Hi everybody, my name is Melody Spradley.
I'm the owner of Melody Photography. And I was asked to show you how I edited and retouched this picture. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and tell you now. I used frequency separation and dodging and burning for my, that was mainly what I did. And then I finished with some other actions and basic thingies that I'll go ahead and do on my other picture. I'm not going to edit this image, but I'm going to do the same technique on another image. So this, I'm going to go ahead and show you. This is what I started out with. It's going to load that. This is the original image without anything done to it, except for like basic exposure, things that I did in Lightroom, which I don't even know if this one needed anything. But anyway, it started out, it's a good image, she likes it, she looks pretty, but it's a close-up and you can see all of her acne that she's very self-conscious about. And she asked me to get rid of it and I said, okay, that's fine. This was before I knew anything about frequency separation because I just learned that technique 2 weeks ago. And this image is only the second time that I've ever used it on anything. Which, I don't know why I did that, I was a crazy person. But anyway, so I didn't know anything about it. And I asked other photographers, I went and looked things up, I did random things on my own, and nothing worked. Until I finally took the time to sit down and spend hours of my time learning frequency separation. And this is what happened because of that. I managed to get a decent picture of her. And her skin was clear. It looked natural. She likes it. It's completely gone. The color's good. It still is in depth. I don't know why it's doing that. It's still in depth. You can still look, you can get up close and you can still see the sharpness of it is still intact. You can still see the healthy little pores all over her face. If you can see a little bit right there. And it looks good. It looks natural. It looks like she does not have any problems with her skin whatsoever. And that is what we're going for here. We're going for the most natural look, and this is the only way that you can get that. Now, as I said, I'm pretty new, and I'm actually really flattered that y'all asked me to do this, but I want to go ahead and do it anyway, despite me being a newbie, because I want y'all to see just how in-depth this can go, and actually how easy it is once you do it. Now that I know this, it's probably not going to be something that I use for everything because it's so detail oriented, but it's something that I'm definitely going to use for all the pictures that where they ask me specifically to get rid of big things like acne and marks, scars, whatever. I'll definitely offer them this option. They'll have to pay extra because it does take a lot of time, but this is definitely one of the things that I would do for those. And for any images that I just want to do just for fun to practice on, or for the ones that are probably higher up, like my favorite images, or an image for something more commercial, a magazine, whatever, that, or something that I just want to take to a higher level. So it's not something that I'm going to do for every image, but it's definitely going to be for the harder images that need this, like this picture, or for the images that they don't necessarily need it, but doing it will just bring it to that next level, the one that normal people with fancy cameras can't even copy unless they know how to do this. So I'm going to show you what image I'm actually going to be doing frequency separation on, and why I decided to go ahead and learn this technique. So I've already posted this image. She's already seen this and she liked it, but of course she doesn't know. She's not a photographer. And I showed it. This is actually not my original edit, me personally. This is what we came up with after me posting the original and asking people
what they thought I should do. I had a whole bunch of people help me out. Thank you all. And I combined all of the efforts, all the advice, all the opinions, all the techniques, and this is what I came up with. And as you can see, it's not that good. See, we're going to zoom in, and I'm going to show you just how bad it is. Well, I might zoom in. I don't know. My computer has decided it doesn't want to. All right, we're going to zoom in some more. Let's zoom in some more. All right, zoom in just a little more. Just a little bit. All right, we're going to stop right here. So I'm going to show you. All right, so I don't really... I just use basic things. I use a little bit of a blur, a little bit of brush technique. I sharpened it afterwards to try to keep that texture. It did not work. See, right here is a sharpening gone bad. It's just a random splotch of sharp, and I don't even know what it's supposed to be sharpening it. There's nothing really there. See, I did this all over her face, but for some reason, it only popped up right here. It does not look good. So, and then we can go down here and we can see like a line. There's a line between the smoothing and then her original skin. It does not look good. You can definitely see that. And if you can already see, like, here's a random blotch of color that didn't get smoothed right, and it looks fake and plasticky, and especially whenever I uploaded it to Facebook, like, this was just the whole face, this little area, that was just how the whole face looked. I don't know why I just did that, but yeah, it just not a good, it was a decent effort. I really appreciate all the help and advice that I got to come up with this, because this was definitely way better than how I edited it the first time on my own. But you can still see it still looks pretty fake. And even if I could spend more time just perfecting all the smoothing in this way, and it would still come out looking plasticky and having this random thingy that I don't know. I guess I didn't know what to sharpen, so it just chose a spot and stuck with it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to totally scratch this whole picture. I'm going to delete it, and I'm going to start from scratch, and I'm actually going to record the new version for y'all to see exactly how I do it. Now I'm going to keep a couple of layers over here. I have so many layers that I don't need. Now I'm going to keep a couple of layers over here because they're not really too important. This is the original image almost. So I'm going to keep this truck removal and stray hairs. I'm going to keep those in here so I don't have to redo them, because all they are is getting rid of this and getting rid of this. So I didn't want to do that all over again. It took me a little bit of time, and I don't need to spend more time doing that when it already looks okay. So these are very basic. If you don't know how to do it, you just go over here to the brush tool, clone stamp, which I didn't know how to do it until somebody told me on this picture. So yeah, this was my first time using these to get rid of something. So you just alt select and then paint over with the clone tool, or you use the brush tool and you can just do this and pick the color and you can just paint over it. And that's how I got rid of these, because, I mean, Content Aware is a great tool, but it did not know what to do with this truck. It did not know what to do with these hairs. So there was nothing really else for me to do besides you do it manually myself. So we're going to go ahead and start. And what we're going to do is we're going to make copies of the background. Now, I am a PC user, and I don't really know anything about Macs. So if you are on a Mac, I'm really sorry. You're going to have to look up the equivalent of all the things that I'm going to tell you to do in the shortcuts. But I do know this one. I know to make a copy of the background, if you're on a Mac, you would do Command J. If you're on a PC, you do Control J. So we're going to make two copies of this background. And for the first one, I'm going to call it Color. The second one, I'm going to call it Texture.
That was really easy. Let me go ahead and get rid of that so we can pretend like we're starting all over again. Alright, that is really all you had to do right there. Now we're going to go to the color layer. You're going to go up here to filter, blur, and this thing, the G one. Gaussian, I don't know what it is, but we're going to go to it. And what you want to do, what you want to do is you want to zoom out. Well, you don't have to, but I'm going to just to show you. What you want to do is get it to where you can still see the color of her skin and her everything, but there's no texture. Now see when I go all the way to 0.2, you can still see the bumps and how sharp they are and how it's obvious that there is acne here. These are pimples or whatever they are, and you can definitely see them. Now I want to get it to where you can make out that it's still a face, it's still a human being, but it's like you're looking at someone without your glasses on and you can't actually tell what they are. It's just a blob of color. And you want to do that really good. Now you don't want to go overboard, because then when you go to start editing, it's gonna remember the lines on my first edit, it's gonna do that if you overdo it. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go to 11. Okay. Well, I did 11. Once you're done finding your scale of whatever you want to do for whatever picture you're working on, go ahead and press OK. And wait for it to finish. Now, if you're doing this, it can take a while, especially if it's your first time doing this. And I would suggest making sure that you've eaten, you've gotten sleep, and that you have water nearby, because if you spend too much time on this, if you're like me, I don't like starting things and stopping before it's done. So I can spend 2, 3, 4 hours on an image and not do anything else but hunch over and stare at my computer screen. And that's not only bad for my back, but it's also bad for my eyes, and I have migraines, so by the time I'm done editing one picture, I'm basically immobile. I can't do anything. I have to go lay down and go to sleep because I'm stupid and I don't listen to my body when it says to stop staring at a computer screen and get up and go do something active. So I've learned that I need to have water and food nearby, and that I need to listen when my body says to stop. Alright, so let me uncheck the texture. Now, so this is what it's going to look like when you're done doing that. Alright, just a basic blur over the whole image. You can see that you can see that it's a girl, but there's not any texture for you to work with. It's all right here. Big difference. Alright, so now you're going to go to the texture. And what we're going to do here, this is just the setup. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to first go up to your image, and you're going to see, does this little thing say 8 or 16? Mine says 16, so that's going to affect what we do here. And I'm going to show you both ways. But I have a 16-bit image, so it's going to affect. So it doesn't matter whether you have an 8 or 16, you're going to go to image and apply image. Now, if you have a 16 like me, I've already done this for you. You're going to make sure that this layer says color. You're going to make sure it's inverted, because it just needs to be inverted. You want it to have that gray. It needs to be at add. And the scale is going to be 2. The offset is going to be 0. Now, if you have an 8, if you have an 8-bit image, if this little number says 8, you're going to make sure the layer is on color still. You're not going to invert it. You're going to go to subtract, and the scale is going to be 2 to 128. Now it looks the same, but it does matter. There's a small difference. So I am 16, so I'm going to go back to my original thing. So whichever one you have, once you put those numbers in, go ahead and press OK. And it's going to take a minute to apply that image. All right.
Give it a moment.
I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and include the links to the two videos that I use to learn these techniques. What the pictures that they use are way not as in-depth as this one, because they're just like commercial images, it looks like to me. Just regular portraits or magazine images that they just do this stuff to, just to make them look a little better. This one is one that actually shows you how far you can go with it. Their versions are definitely just a good thing for your first time. Just use an image, an easy image, just so you can get the hang of it, and then you can go ahead and come back to an image like this and see just how far you can go. So we're going to make sure we make a copy of the color layer. We're going to call it color edit. Ooh. And add a layer mask. And then you're going to go to texture, and you're going to make a copy of the texture layer. And you're going to call this texture edit. And you're going to add a layer mask. Now, I don't really care if you call it texture edit. That's just what I want to call mine. I want to call mine edits, because that's what I'm going to be doing on them. I'm going to be editing those layers. Now, I don't know if you just saw what I just did. All right. Go between the texture and the copy that you just made, and I'm a PC user again, so I don't know what you Mac users are going to do, but I'm going to press Alt, and I'm going to go in between here, and I'm going to click until, like, I'm going to go in between until this little thingy pops up, and I'm going to click, and that just puts this texture edit on the texture, which you're going to need. You don't need to do that with the color, but you need to do that with the texture, because you're going to be editing the texture edit layer, and the texture layer is going to be making that to where you can't see it. So this is going to make it to where you can edit it on this layer, but you can still see it how you're supposed to. Now go back to texture one more time, and you're going to change the blending mode to linear light, just on the texture layer, not the edit. Alright, so once you're done with that, go ahead and select all four of these. Click on color, shift, texture edit, and go down here to the little group icon. And I'm going to call this FS. You can call it frequency separation. You can call it freak set. You can call it, I don't know, whatever. You can call it marshmallows if you want to. But I'm going to call it FS so I know what it is. So I'm going to turn it on and off, and as you can see, these two canceled each other out. They made it to where it looks the same. Now if you just go to the color edit, or the color layers, you're going to see it's all blurry. And if you turn these off, and you turn on the texture layers, you're going to see it's very, 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 very sharp, because it's taking all the sharpness of the image, and it's doing it again, basically. And so now you have twice as much sharpness as you started out with. You have twice as much texture. And if you put this back on it, it looks normal again. So that's the whole point of frequency separation. You're trying to separate color and texture and edit them separately and then put them back together. So we're going to go ahead and start on the color edit layer. Now you can work with it with everything selected if you want to, but in my opinion, it does make it easier for you to just work on this color layer, because you're only looking at color. You're not looking at anything else. You only want to look at color and blending it in to look good. Now, I'm going to zoom in just a little bit so I can see her face. And I'm going to press the lasso tool. Lasso tool's up here. The shortcut for it is just L, as you can see. Now, I have a feather up here. I don't really know. You can do, I'm going to just choose a random number. I'm going to choose 5. And the feather, it just,
here, we can do a little select. Go to Hue, and you can just see, like, I put it at 50. Oops, I didn't put it at 50, I put it at something else. You can just see what it's doing there, just looking at it. Now I'm going to use mine. It's not really doing very much, but I'm going to use mine at 5. I want mine to feather. Okay, I'm going to exit that quick mask. That was Q, by the way, if you're wondering. But anyway, so what you're going to do here is you're just going to select whatever it is you want to select. And you're going to press Control or Command F. And what that does is that takes whatever selection you just selected and it blurs it a little bit more, blends it in a little bit more. Let's go to 30. Alright. So let's take this little mark right here. Command F, Command F. And now it's gone just because it blended it in with colors around it. And you're just going to go around the face or the arm or the leg or whatever you're working on, and you're just going to do that a bunch. Now make sure, like I have... Make sure whenever you're doing it, you don't want to have it so high to where there's an obvious line. So, let's go show you what I mean by that. The blur, causing blur. I have mine at 11. Now, if I had it at 48, show you what. See, once you were finished, it would just have this random line. That's not what we're looking for here. I'm gonna put it back in 11. I'm gonna have it. Actually, I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make mine at 13. And that's all you're doing. You're just making sure you're just blending in colors, and you're going all over whatever it is you're working on. Any of the colors that you don't like or that aren't matching what's around it, and just lasso it, Control F. Select it, Control F. Control F. Control F. Control F. Make sure you're paying attention, because you want to try to get as much of it done in this part, this step as possible. Okay. There's one more thing after we're finished with this that we'll do, just to fine tune it. But for the most part, this is what you're doing on the color layer. Now the reason I put the masks on these layers is simply because, let's see, let's do this. I just blurred that. I'm gonna blur it again. Okay, so I just blurred that a whole bunch. Now I just have this random blur. I can just go over here, take my brush, and I can just erase that. Oops. Well, yeah, we can't see it because the background's not selected, but I can just erase it. See, it's not there anymore. No, then I don't really care. That's just why that's there. So now that that's over, now we can go back and continue doing what we're doing. I think I'm just about done doing what I wanted to do with the face. I think I'm done with the lasso tool. I'm about to show you what comes next.
Alright, alright, so I'm going to go ahead and show you what we have. Alright, so this is what we just did. This is what we started with. So I just went around selecting a bunch of things and blending them in with each other. Alright, now we're not done because you can still see there's still little blotchy marks. But we did make a lot of progress just by using the lasso tool and Control F. Or Command F, whatever. Alright, so now we're going to finish. Go to the brush tool. And you can right click and go down to here. Or you can just press Shift B until you get to this brush up here. Now, you can go ahead and copy my settings. If you can't see them, I have it to where the little X is the only thing selected. The thing right next to it's not selected. Have it custom. Don't want anything over here checked off. And then wet 20, load 20, mix 20, and flow 30. And that's what you're gonna have. Alright. Now. Alright, what you're gonna do once you have all that put in. What you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and go to your picture and find a color that you like. Okay, so I have all these red blotchy marks, and I don't like them, but her actual skin color looks to be this yellowish white kind of thing. So I'm going to Alt and select, and I'm just going, well, you don't actually have to Alt select, but all you're going to do is you're just going to click right here, and you're going to drag to where you want to cover it up. Now make sure you're not dragging, like I wouldn't want this, I wouldn't want to start here and drag this way, because it's going to make all of this really red eventually, and I don't want that. You can drag up, you can drag in curves, you can drag down, you can drag however you want to drag, but just make sure whatever you're dragging is the color that you actually want to be changing it to. And this is just to finish off the face and smooth the colors out a little more, get rid of any blotchiness that you might have, and all that good stuff. Now, in case you're wondering, it took me forever to figure this out, but in case you're wondering, I don't know how new you are if you're watching this. In case you're wondering how I'm just changing the size of my brush without touching anything, it's right next to the P on your keyboard, the little two weird bracketing marks. The left one makes it smaller, the right one makes it bigger. And that's all that is. I don't know. I just felt like I wanted to share that because I could never figure out how people were doing that until I saw a video and someone told me, and I was like, oh. Alright. You can kind of see what's going on here with this. Make sure it's all smoothed out. And remember, again, there's a reason we have a mask over here, so if you mess up at all, you can just go back. See, you know, this is a little weird, but we're going to fix it later. I don't want to spend too much time on that. Alright. I just want to make sure her face evened out. I don't want a bunch of red. I want her to have a pretty even face color. No, over here where her eye is kind of sunken in. You don't want it to really be sunken in, so I'm bringing the lighter part. I'm dragging that lighter part up underneath her eye. I'm going to do it over here too. Just to make sure. Alright, no. I kind of like this color. I'm going to put that in there. A lot of detail. Alright, now here, you might not be able to see it, but I noticed it in the previous image that I did of her, so I want to make sure I get it. There's like a little pimple thingy up there, and I just want to make sure I kind of smooth out the color of it, so it's not as obvious. Alright, make sure, let's get over here. Right now, you might be thinking right now, you're looking at the image and you're like, oh, this is really cool, it's getting rid of all that color, but it's making her face look really fake, and I thought you said you did not want that to be the case. Well, I don't. And that is why, after we're done here doing the frequency separation, we finish with dodging and burning. Dodging and burning is so simple, but it is like the difference in the picture. It really makes the image when you're done. Alright, so I think I don't really know what's going on over here. This chin is kind of confusing me, but I think I'm going to go ahead and say that I'm done. There we go. Okay, I think I'm going to go ahead and say I'm done. So, let's show the before. This is the before, and this is after. See, I messed up a little bit of her hair over here. I can easily fix that. Go ahead and go back to a normal brush. And just kind of... Oh, yeah. Just kind of... go back and fix that. See? Now it's back. So we can just see what we've done. Well, I actually painted that black. I didn't mean to do that. Oops. I'm going over here. Oh, that doesn't want to work right now. We'll figure it out later. Well, anyway, you can see what you've done. See, I definitely smoothed out this chin a lot. Got rid of the cheeks colors. Got rid of the pimple on the nose. Lightened up her under eyes a little bit. It does look a little overdone, but we're going to see what dodging and burning can do with that. Alright, so now you can add back in the texture layer. And once you add back in the texture layer, it's amazing because even though we just spent all that time getting rid of all the acne color, the texture layer comes back in and it says, ha, it's still all here because all those bumps were on her skin. And you can just see them. It was part of her skin. It was part of the texture on her skin because the pores weren't small and pretty. They were bumpy and bigger. So that's what you get. Now, the color still definitely looks a lot smoother than the original. It definitely looks a little flat, but we're going to fix that. But you can definitely see the color-wise, the picture looks pretty good. Alright, now we're going to go to the texture layer. Now, you can edit the texture layer all by itself. The thing about it is, because it's all grayscale, it's kind of hard to see. And sometimes I'll edit it all by itself, but most of the time it's easier to edit it on top of everything else. Oops. Alright, so we've kind of sort of finished the color. Like, there's still a few things that I could do with it, but or undo with it, but it's okay. We're gonna leave it.
Now we're going to go back up here. Okay, so you can use the clone stamp or the healing brush. It really doesn't matter which one you use for the texture. They'll both work. But I'm going to go ahead and use the healing brush. So then this is a little, this calls to get a little closer because you really want to make sure you get everything that you can get. All right. You can just, you choose your source point with Alt and click. And then, oh, I don't know. Why it's doing that. Oh, there it goes. I don't know. But you just choose your source point with Alt and click, and you just kind of drag it over wherever you want to fix texture wise. So you can't really see the pimple because her hair is kind of covering it up there. So I'm not really worried about showing up there. No. Now this is kind of does take a little bit more time because you actually have to go through and get all of the little bumps. You want to make sure all of the little bumps are gone. And it's going to take a little bit of time. What I like to do is I like to choose a really smooth point, which seems to be up here, the smoothest. And just watch, make sure you watch the little area that's up here whenever you're down here, the little cross, because it'll move and you want to make sure it doesn't move into a place that's uneven, like down here, because then you'll just be copying all that. See, you don't want to do that. So just make sure you keep an eye of where your source point is, and after that, other than that, you're good as long as you keep an eye on that. You can start to see the texture is kind of smoothing up a little. And I can go back and fix those weird little bumps later. Right now, I'm just worried about getting the majority of it done. I don't know if I mentioned this already, but I'm sorry if the quality of this video is kind of off. I kind of just have the basic, very basic tools to work with, so my bad. I don't want to go that far. See, there's like this way. This doesn't really look like acne. It just looks like a little scratch. I'm gonna get rid of it. Now, here's one. This little pimple thing right here, we're probably gonna have to use the clone stamp tool to get rid of that, because that is actually on the outside of her face, and there's not really any way for us to heal it without blurring it and making it look unnatural and weird. So we're probably going to have to do a little bit extra work to get that. Alright, so this side of the cheek is going to be a little harder because there's a lot less smooth skin to work with. So what I'm going to have to do is make my brush teeny tiny. I'm going to start right here, and I'm going to very carefully smooth up part of the face. I don't like using this side of the face to do this side because then it all looks the same. So I'm going to go ahead and smooth up this part of the face using that tiny little smooth part, and then once I think I have an area big enough to work with, I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger and use that as my source. That wasn't big enough. Almost done with her face. Okay, this will have to go do that in just a minute. Alright, let me go ahead and see if I can do this and smooth that up. Go to the clone stamp tool and make that smaller, and I guess we're just going to use this background and try to see if we can totally undo that. I don't know what this is. And copy. I might have to go ahead and Try to do that later for the sake of the video. I'm just gonna go ahead and mute it for now. Alright, so we're gonna go back up to 16 point whatever it was. And this is what we have done. This is the before and after. Now, as you can see, it's very flat. And that is where dodging and burning is going to come in handy. Very, very flat. Now, it does look a lot better in terms of clarity? I don't know. It looks better. But it definitely lost a lot of depth. See, and this was, you could see her cheekbones over here. You could see the shadows under her nose. See the shadow under her face, under her, around her lips, because her lips poked out just a little bit. And now you have no shadow under her face. Well, just a tiny bit. No shadow over here. There's no shadow under her eyes at all. There's no cheekbone definition. You lost a lot of shadow around her nose, and there's absolutely nothing under her lips anymore. And while her skin is definitely cleared up, there's no definition. She almost looks like a painting. So we're gonna go ahead and do the next step. Actually, before I do that, I'm gonna go into the color edit one more time. You might have to do this a few times. Oh well. See, and that's what I mean. This video is a perfect example of how long this stuff can take. Now, luckily, the dodging and burning really shouldn't take that long. But it definitely shows you how long that something like this can take. Alright. Okay. Well, I don't really know. Alright, so here's the next part. That's frequency separation. We just did most of it just in that little bit right here. But now you're going to go ahead and take your background and you're going to make two copies. You're going to name one Dodge or Lightning. You name the other Burn. Now, to remember, I used to get these mixed up a lot as well. Go ahead and put those in a group. But it's really actually really easy, and then once I heard this, I thought it was really dumb that I didn't know the difference. But dodging is lighten, and there's not really a way to remember that. But burning, when you burn something, typically it gets darker. I can't think of anything that you could burn that gets lighter from being burnt. So that's how you know. Burn is darken, dodge is lighten. Alright, so go to your dodge layer and go back to your brush. And you don't need this one anymore. You just need a normal brush. You're gonna make your flow. You can bring your opacity up all the way, and you're gonna make your flow actually pretty low. Typically, it's between 5% and 10%, and V being the little stuff that I'm gonna put it right in the middle of that, 7.5%. Now you can make it 5, you can make it 10, you can make it 8, 9, 7, 6, whatever you wanna do. I'm going to make it 7.5 because I don't know why. Now, when
you when I dodge, I usually do use white. But when I burn, which we'll go to this later, burn, I don't use black. I sample her face, which looks like, oh, I'm being a dummy. I just did something really dumb. You're gonna have to make a new layer, not a copy. My bad. So make, I didn't say groups. Okay, sorry, make a new layer, two new layers, and name one dodge, the other burn. Yeah, it doesn't make sense to make a copy of the background when you just fixed the background. So, let's go back. Now what was I saying? Oh, right. Dodge is lighten, burn is darken. Okay, so whenever I dodge, I do use complete white, but whenever you burn, you don't, yeah, I mean, you can use black, but usually I'll sample the skin color, and I'll just make it a little darker, and that's the color that I'm going to use for burning. I don't use all the way black, but that's that. All right, so there's two rules for dodging and burning. The first rule, rule numero uno, is you dodge or lighten where there was already lights or on the highlights, and you burn or darken on the shadows or the parts that were already dark. And the second rule is you typically want to dodge or lighten on where you want to bring attention to, and you want to darken on things that you don't want attention brought to. So now I'm using dodging and burning just to bring back detail and depth into her face, but I can also do it when I'm done. I can go back and dodge just on her face where I want people to see, like her cheekbones and lips, and her hair maybe, and I can go back and burn where I don't want people to look, which is, I mean, I don't really care if people look at her shirt or not, and I'm sure that's just one example, but, I mean, I guess I could burn it around her nostrils, I don't know, but that's the basics for dodging and burning. So I'm going to go ahead and show you. Now I'm going to go ahead and start. I have my flow, well, it does not want 7.5, so I'm going to make it 7. I'm going to have, zoom in again so I can see her face, because that's where we're working. So at first it's going to be pretty obvious. See, now I'm pretty new at this. Some of you might not be. I don't know why you would be watching this if you weren't. But if you need to see, like, where you want to be painting because you just can't see it on your own, you can go ahead and, like, close the frequency separation. Go ahead and look at the background just to look. See, we have the highlight, a little bit of a highlight right here, which I was already going to highlight because that's where her cheekbones, that's where I want them to be. And you have highlights on the top of her nose. You have highlights under a little bit under her eyes, which I'm going to get rid of the shadows under her eyes completely. I'm just going to highlight under there. And you have a little bit of highlight right here in this little curve. You have highlight right above her lips. You can even go so far as to highlight these little parts, the ridges above her lips. Everybody has those. And I'll probably also go so far as to go on the lips and actually highlight between the little crevices. And so that's where those highlights are. And then burning, you want to add a shadow back underneath because it just looks weird without one. There's a shadow on the other side of her nose. There's shadows at the same time in these ridges, in her lips, all that stuff. So if you don't know where shadows and highlights are supposed to be, you can go ahead and look at the original image and just find where the light is coming from and look at it and try to replicate it on this. So I'm going to go ahead and start. Just want to bring a nose, this cheekbone,
is right here. Oh, right. Well, you don't have to, you don't have to do this, but I'm about to do, but I'm going to go ahead and do it because I don't really like painting it like this. You can do this if you want, just so you can see exactly where you're painting, but I don't really like painting this harshly. So if you don't like painting this harshly, you can go ahead and go over here, which is, you're going to do this with both layers anyway. After or before you start painting, go to your dodge and change the blending mode to soft light. Now you're going to go back again and you're going to lower the opacity a little bit more, but this just helps so I don't feel like I'm just making her look like a clown or some kind of weird creature with tribal paint. Over here and lighten up these shadows. There's not very many of them anymore, but okay, so let's see, I got the cheek off, I'm gonna lighten it up a little more. Highlights on this shadow shade. Alright, I'm gonna go zoom in and get the lips. Which, I don't know how far I have to do this. I'm gonna go ahead and adjust these bridges above my lips. I'm gonna add highlight, just a little highlight on that side, a little bit more on this side. Go ahead and go onto her lips and lighten them up a little bit in between crevices. There's a light. Alright. Alright, she still doesn't quite look normal, but it will be okay. Seems like there's a little highlight underneath her. Light is getting that shimmer over here. Just gonna lighten it up like that. Okay. Now I think I've gotten the basics just to bring a little bit of something back into her face. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and double click on this. That'll bring this up, and you can go down here to the dark side of underlying layer. That's what we're going to, and you want to go to the dark side, and you want to press Alt and click, and that'll separate this little thingy. And what that does, as you can see, is that makes it to where your highlights, they stay out of the shadowed area. You can bring the whole thing all the way over here, and it'll just get rid of it completely. And you don't want that, because, I mean, what's the point of putting it on if you're going to just get rid of it completely? But you can go ahead and you can toggle this and move it to wherever you want to move it. Oops, I totally re-separated them. Okay. You can toggle this and move it to wherever you want to move it to just kind of make sure it stays out of your shadowed areas. Which, I mean, I want to keep it under the eye, but I don't want it to be really blatant, and I want to keep it right here, but again, I don't want it to be ridiculous. So this is what I'm going to start out with, and I'm going to just move it down. I'm going to move it down just about halfway, which it still looks a little overdone, but of course, I'm not done yet. So now I'm going to go to burn, and like I said, I'm going to go ahead and go to a darker part of her skin, and I'm just going to use that for my burning. And I'm going to go burn in all the places that I don't really want people to look at, and in the places that, oh, again, you can change it to soft light. So, I don't really care if people look over here. I don't really care. And I definitely The thing about when you use it is it can add a little bit of color. Like, she wasn't this brown before, and I am painting over her with brown, so she's going to be a little more brown than she actually really looks. So if you don't want that, you'll just have to go back in afterwards and bring down that saturation a little bit. Flat. So I'm gonna thin this burn everywhere that I can. Back on these ridges above the lips, I'm gonna bring that definition in the crevices. I like the way that looks, so you don't have to know if you want to, but I'm going to do that on the opposite side of the lid. Alright, so she still looks like a clown. We're going to go ahead and do the same thing, only on the opposite. You're going to start the lighter end, not the darker end, underlying layer, asphalt. And this will keep it out of your areas that are supposed to be highlighted. I'm going to go ahead and move to right there. Alright, so this is your dodging and burning. And of course, it's totally overdone, even though you have them. So you're going to have to probably... I'm going to get my eraser and just kind of erase. Right here, I have it at 52, so that's good. I need to do a little less than that. Just don't want that much of it. I'm going to go ahead and bring it down, bring down my opacity to where it's not just crazy. I'm going to bring it down to 56. I'm going to bring down this to still looks. The thing about dodging and burning is sometimes you get so used to looking at it one way, this way, that you just, your eyes don't like the look of when you add that depth back in, which is kind of what's happening to me right now, I think, because it looks overdone to me right now, and I'm pretty sure that that's not overdone, but I'm kind of not really sure. So, yeah. So let's see, this is what I am dealing with here. I might bring it back a little stronger. I'm going to go ahead and look and see. That's my ring. This is, yeah, I'm going to need to bring this up a little more. Okay. So let's bring that burn up to 45. I'm going to dodge. To... 85. I'm going to bring that up to 50, I think. Alright. Mm. the before and the after. All right, again, bring the burn down a little bit. Let's bring it down to 40. All right, I think that looks all right. We just want to make sure we have that detail added back in there. There we go. It looks a little better like that. Okay. Let's see. Now, I think what I could do is I could go back in here. Now that I'm looking at that, and I see there's like a little ridge on her chin that is now gone. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to try to add that back in. And it looks like it was dodge above this little area here and a little burn right above it. Actually, you know what? That makes more sense for me to just follow it. Wow. Really dumb. See what I'm doing now, which I've never had to actually totally redo the shadows in anybody's face before, so I'm actually looking at it. I'm just following with my brushes where they're already. Oh my. Why do I do that? Where there are already highlights and shadows. See. Alright, let's add that back in, and now, there we go. Now it looks like I've done a decent job of bringing back that little thing. Alright. See, this brings it all the way down. I don't want to do that. Okay. Alright, now that I've done that a little bit, I'm going to go back with my eraser. I'm just gonna lightly go over this because I think it looks good, but it's just a little too much. I'm not thinking of the dodging needs to be redone. Alright. So there is my before. This is after. Before. After. And there's the complete without the stray hairs and all that. So this is before, after. Again, that's the frequency separation. Alright, so see frequency separation, you see the dodging and the burning. It brings back the depth into her face, which we definitely needed. And then getting rid of the background. Okay, so we have just done the hardest parts. Now, there's actually another way
you can dodge and burn, which I'm gonna, I've only done it once, so I'm gonna attempt to show y'all. I'm gonna go ahead and make two new layers. Dodge. And this is, I'm gonna call it lazy dodge, because that's what it is. Lazy dodge and lazy burn. Alright, so this is the lazy dodging and burning way, as I said. And we're gonna kind of utilize a couple things that we learned, just the detail oriented way. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna just take your brush and you're going to choose white. And you're just going to paint all over her face, and wherever else. Wherever else you want to do this. It's not letting me. I don't know why. Well, anyway. I guess I'll just do it on her face until I figure out what's going on. So, I just painted all over her face. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and change it. Give it a minute. Alright. I don't know why it's not letting me paint anywhere else. I wonder if I should bring it down underneath this. Oh, that's weird. Well, I don't know. I'll figure that out later. Well, anyway, okay, so I've done that. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and do the thing where you click on it, and you're going to go ahead and you're going to click on that, and you drag that all the way to the other side, the dark all the way to the light, and then you mess with this. Now, let me leave that. Now remember, it's still going to be soft light. Okay. You just... not that. So, you just paint over her face, and then you separate this, and you drag it, and that just gets it out of the shadow areas completely, and you can mess with this to see exactly where you want it. I'm going to go ahead and put it right there. That looks good. And now we have a lazy dodge, and we're going to do the same thing with lazy burn. Alright. Lazy burn, you got to be a little bit more careful with it. You don't want to do it all over her face like you did with dodge, because it'll come out a little weird. So you only want to put it kind of where you want it on the face. So, alright, there, I've gotten it. You want to do it pretty dark, but I know exactly where I want it. Alright, again, this is going to be soft light, click on it. Now the opposite, you're going to separate it and bring it all the way out of the highlights, and then you're just going to do this to see where exactly you want it. And I'm going to go ahead and put it right here. That looks good to me. Alright. And now you have the lazy burn. You can bring down the opacity a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and group these as well. And then we'll call it lazy. Alright. And now we have our lazy D&B and our regular D&B, which I'm going to bring down the opacity since we have this. Now the thing about the lazy dodge and burn, it's not really what I would use to just use lazy D&B to do the whole image. I would not do that. But it is a good way to get the basics done. It's actually really crazy how easy it is. It's a really good basic way just to get that back into her face. But I wouldn't do just that for the whole image. I'd actually combine it like I did here with
the detailed dodge and burn, because I think it just looks a little better when you kind of go in yourself and you shape it just exactly how you want it. So this is how you started, frequency separation, and then dodge and burn brings back in that depth. So you start out like this, you end up like this. It's actually a very, very good overall image. And again, let me go in. That's really the basics of how I did that. And I'm going to go ahead and bring y'all back in really close so y'all can see. I know you already saw, but now you can go back in and you can look around. And you can see her skin is clear, the color looks good, the shadows and highlights are good, and it still has kept intact with the pores, and it's not an overall sharp image, so that's why it's not like super, super, super sharp, but I'm sure those of you who have a better camera than me, this is a very good way to get the color and the texture to be perfect. So for our purposes, it actually looks pretty good. Alright, that's the before and after. Now I can go ahead and show you what I do with all my images. I can go ahead and, I am a big fan of MCP, so what I can do is I can go ahead and edit this how I would edit it if I was actually doing this. I'm going to go ahead and use, I love, love, love Inspire, which is what I'm about to use right now. I'm going to go ahead and use Inspire. I'm going to use the Quick Flash. I just want to do basic things right now. I'm going to go ahead and use Sun Drenched, Quick Flash, and go down here to Drama. This is my basic. I almost always use Drama for every single one of my images that I ever edit. I almost always use Drama because it gives me everything I want to do. I'm usually more of the contrast and pop kind of girl, so I use Drama to get all of that. I like bold colors, I like the contrast, I like emphasizing the darks and the lights, and so Drama gives me the chance to do all of that with one simple tool, and I don't have to worry about making my own layers and all that. So I like doing manual edits a lot of the time just because I have a little bit of control, but I also love actions when I just want to get through something, or if I'm looking for a specific look and I already know that there's an action out there that has that look, and so I'm just going to go ahead and use it. So let's let it finish that, and I'll go ahead and show y'all what I do to finish after the dodging and the burning and the frequency separation. I used to go overboard. Sometimes I still do, but usually when I do frequency separation and dodging and burning, I kind of feel like I don't need to go overboard because that's such a drastic change. So it helps me keep my edits more natural after that. Well, let's let it finish. This is just basic stuff. The image is actually, the little histogram is actually right in the middle for the exposure, so it really doesn't need to be lightened exposure wise but I feel like it's a little too dark anyway, maybe because the shadow, I don't know, but I'm going to go ahead and lighten it up anyway just because I think it needs to be lightened up a little more. So as y'all saw with this video, the length of it, you can see how long it can take. Now this video took a little longer than it would actually take me because I was going through and perfecting everything and showing y'all what to do and going through a little more. And I wouldn't spend time explaining things and doing things when I'm working by myself. Obviously, I'm not going to talk to myself and tell myself how everything is supposed to look. But But it did take me a little longer, but it still shows you how long this can take. But in the end, it was all worth it. I think you'll agree that it was all worth it. And I'm going to go ahead, after I finish showing you my favorite actions, if it ever finishes, I'm going to go ahead and go back and show y'all this version versus the first version that I did without using frequency separation. So, let's go ahead and wait for that, and maybe someday it might make it to the end of the line. I don't know what happened. It might have died or something. Those separately. We go down to drama. This is the one I really wanted to show y'all because I absolutely love, love, love this action. Alright. So, this is what I do basically every single time I pull this up. I go ahead and use it. Oh, I might want to change my flow back to 100%. Alright, I go ahead and use it. I want, which in this case I'm going to use it on her hair. And on her eyes. You can see that did that. Now I don't want to use it at full opacity. I'm going to go ahead and lower it down. 30% looks okay. Let's go in. This is really why I really want to show you. Alright, so this is what I use. There's an eye action, eye doctor and dentist by MCP that does this for you as well, but it's kind of easier if it's kind of easier since I'm already going to be using drama. It already has this listed. Unless I have something else to darken or lighten, I usually just use this to do this. I just go in and I just kind of paint over. Oops. I just like to paint over the lash line, especially since she's already got long lashes, but I'm going to just kind of enhance them a little bit. She did not wear makeup at all. So, and I like that cat eye look. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that into effect. Alright, and then we're going to go right here at the edge of her eye, and I'm going to darken all around the edge of her eye. Oops, not the outside. Just the inside. And do the same for the other eye. Alright, and now we're going to go to the brighten, and we're going to bring that all around. I don't want to get the pupil. I want to keep the pupil dark, but I want to bring out that color in her eye. Alright, so when you go back out, it looks way overdone. So, I'm just going to do brighten. I want to bring that color out. This is original. I think it's a little too dark for me, but definitely that's way too high. So, I'm going to bring it right in the middle. I think that works for my purposes. And here's the darken. Again, the darken is a little overdone, so I'm just going to bring it down probably to about 25%. And now we have that. Alright, now I'm going to bring out the color in her eyes. I'm going to go back down to her eyes. I'm going to use this vivid color that's included in her eyes. Not the vivid color, I mean the deep color. And I'm going to bring it around her eyes. Just in those colored parts. And the last thing I want to do, I don't need to use the blurry. Sometimes I use the blurry on the skin, but I don't need to because I already got it really good with the frequency separation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use Clarity. I'm going to use this brush, and I'm going to brush it over her eyes because I want them to pop out a little more. And I'm going to bring it over her hair because I like the hair. I can go ahead and use this, bring it over her shirt because I don't really care about her shirt. Like I said, bring it back. I already have a depth of focus going on, but I'm going to blend the background. So what you end up is with something like this. It's not a huge change, but I think it is. Actually, you know what? Because the deep color darkens and brings out the vividness of the color, I'm going to go ahead and brighten her eyes up back a little more. So this is what you're going to end up with. You got her eyes look a little better. You can see the color in them. You can see the color of her hair. You get a little bit of contrast going on. And the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and use this darken for the shirt as well. And I'm going to bring it down to 50% opacity. And I'm going to darken the shirt. Oh, well, now you can see it darkened a little bit. Actually, I'm going to bring it back to 100. Alright. I'm going to do this thing. So, yeah, that's all that did. Alright, so now, one more time. Before, after. Before, after. I kind of want to bring it down just a little bit more. So there, I did my thing, and I did it, and I brought it down to, I'm going to bring it down to 33%. And we're going to lighten up the whole picture. That's a little too bright, but I'm going to bring it down to, how about 14? No, it's a little too bright. We're going to bring it down to 10%. And that gives me 7%. Alright, we're going to stick with 7%. That brightens it up a little more just so you can see it. And then this makes sure her shirt's a little darker so it's not weird. And then I'm kind of a fan of this sunlight thing going on, so I'm going to bring that. We're going to have to bring all of this. We're going to have to bring all of these. I'm going to have to bring all of those up because they are underneath my frequency separation and I can't even see what they are. So, obviously all of these are really good. We do not want that. So, let's see. I'm going to go ahead and use this. I'm going to bring it down a little bit. 15%. I'm going to use sunlight just to warm it up. I don't want to use that much of it though. I'm going to use it at 34. No, I'm not. I'm using it even less than that. 20%. Just to warm it up just a little bit. Yeah, I like that. Don't need any more of that. Alright. So this kind of, I don't know, the action kind of got stopped in the middle of it. So, I'm actually, you know what, I'm just not going to use that at all. Okay. The one thing I want to show you before I end this video is I want to show you what else, another MCP action that I really love that I use almost with everything as well is this Skin Cast Blast that comes with Magic Skin. It is amazing, and half the time I get so confused. I do so many actions, or even if I'm not doing very many actions, my white balance is off, whatever. I try to fix it in Lightroom, it's still not perfect. I can go into Photoshop and do my things and run this action at the end of it, and I can make sure that there's not too much yellow, green, blue, orange, or red. It's very, very handy. A lot of the time I get a lot of yellow tones because I like the warmer look, so I kind of have to go in and just kind of get rid of them. Let's see what else I have. I might have a little bit too much blue. So we're going to kind of get rid of the blue. Not too much though. And let's try to get rid of... She's got a lot of red in her skin, so we're going to try to come over here. And just... I don't want to get rid of it too much, but I think that'll be... That's good. So before, after, it's very subtle, but it gives such a huge, it's so nice to see that I can just go in really quick and get rid of all the weird colors that are coming out. I don't know why they're even there. But I don't think I'm completely done with this image, but I think I'm done with it enough for our purposes. It's very natural looking. Again, her skin looks so much better, and now that I'm done, let me go ahead and show you what I started with and the difference between what I started with and frequency separation. So here we go. This is my attempt at first, just using regular, the brush, the clone stamp, the content aware, and Gaussian blur. And this is after frequency separation and dodging and burning. So it's up to you which one you like more. I like this one more, I'm just saying. But I just wanted to show y'all. Thank you for watching this whole huge video. And I hope this helped y'all learn something and see how much you can do with frequency separation. So now, once you have it, as you can see, it's actually not that hard at all. It's pretty easy. It's just a matter of remembering how to set everything up and how many things that you can do, and you can't go overboard, but you can't do too little with it either. So once you got that, you're good. But anyway, thank y'all, and I will talk or see you later, I guess. Let's go ahead and close it. Bye.